Michael in Lawrenceville, you're on New Jersey 101.5. Good morning, Michael.
Good morning.
Hey, Michael, how are you?
How are you?
Good. So what do you think?
Well, I'm actually calling to attest to Eric Scott. My son is a junior in Lawrence Township, playing varsity football, and learned and refined his skills under Eric Scott.
Wow, that's great to hear. What was it? What was it about the coaching style that you liked that your son responded to?
Safety, making sure that you had your helmet, making sure that you understood the plays, that you were paying attention, learning the rules, playing fair. Really, years later, when he sees flaws and stuff like that, he says, "Wow, Eric would have just run," or Coach Scott, who would never say Eric, Coach Scott would just run right up and down us if we did that wrong. We would run and run and run and, you know, learn from our mistakes.
Yeah.
And it's a formative part of my son's life, and I just want to thank you, Eric.
Yeah. Wow. All right. Well, I'm sure he's heard that, and I will pass that along to him for sure. So, Michael, thank you for calling New Jersey 101.5, and good luck to your son as he continues playing the great sport of American football. Yeah, it's incredible that we it's almost like we don't have these conversations anymore. That you got to get. Especially young boys who can be somewhat a little, you know, all over the place, a little bit high energy, and sometimes they can be reckless if they are not guided in the right way. And this concept of helping young boys become good young men is something that is lost in the conversation. And it really is unfortunate because it's very easy to point to a few things, a few bad situations. I mean, God forbid that, you know, that quarterback in Washington Township who passed away. I mean, there are things that happen that are tragic and awful, and some preventable, some not. But to paint the entire sport with that, I think is wrong. And I just wanted to spend a little time this morning giving that shout out to these youth football coaches, because they step up 6 days a week. It was a long schedule. Truthfully, I wish the season were a little bit longer. I'd like to see Pop Warner extend into November. The kids were really disappointed that the season ended. And, you know, what Eric said was something that you don't hear often, and that is, when a kid makes a mistake, how do you deal with that? You know, we have such a different view in society today that we make a lot of excuses, that you get participation trophies. You know, we lost every game but one. That we didn't get a trophy. That's a good thing. You got to earn the trophy. But what you walk away with are the relationships, the friendships, the mentoring, the understanding of when everybody's going to make a mistake. You're going to be on the hot seat every once in a while. And how you deal with that is, it helps form how you will deal with adversity as you get older.